Recording in progress.
All right, let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for Friday. Thank you that we woke up in our right minds. Thank you that we're here and that we get to move. Enjoy, Lord, as we move, would you meet us in our bodies? Lord, we pray for healing and restoration in our physical bodies, freedom and joy in our emotional selves, Lord, and an intimacy with you that would draw us closer to your heart, God. We recognize that we are spirit, soul, and body. We don't want to neglect any one of those parts. So, Lord, come and meet us in every way. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, so our verse today is 2 Corinthians 3. We're going to read, gosh, the numbers are really small, 16 through 18. So go ahead and start moving. And it says this, it says, then when one turns to the Lord, the veil is removed. He's talking about the veil of the flesh, the veil of unbelief, the veil of not being able to see God. When we turn to him, the veil is removed. Now the Lord is the Spirit. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And we, with unveiled face, beholding the glory of the Lord, are being transformed into the same image from one degree of glory to another. For this comes from the Lord who is the Spirit. So what we're going to focus on today is that unveiled face. We with unveiled face. So exciting. All right, march your jog, shake your arms out. All right, give me a warm-up squat, so be gentle, don't go too deep yet. So this idea of an unveiled face means that there's nothing between us and him. Take it wide.
Veiled before the Lord, and he says, darling, come.
face, and I'll show you mine. And your feet narrow.
Let's go.
Next time you throw me a REM pal.
You know what it is? I love it.
Alright. Wow, it's sweaty. I'm gonna walk in from your camera.
Let's talk about it.
Alright.
Yeah. I've always been a Christian.
Quite
a few years. Victory and faith.
Side to side.
In my fears.
Go to the back.
Words that have tickled me in the ears. That's why I praise God.
Four strong.
The word here. The word became flesh. Lived for 30
years. So you're
years.
Moving from your belly. Three,
but after days reappeared. Jesus Christ anointed one ascended in
two
the
more.
Ear. Or you can say the air where the Father made
right, drop
air.
One weight.
Of all things the Father was more than a chair.
Knee.
But after all redemption, away every tear from my eyes, and death shall be no more.
To to the bottom.
Neither
the
shall
veil
be
that separated
anymore,
us from him was torn, and that means we have free access.
For the former things will pass
there
away.
There is nothing that can keep
and
us
who seated on the
from
throne
his presence.
Behold,
except
I am
us.
Making all things.
Only new. Us. So we get to leave, Lord. Leave it all. Unveiled. Say, run, run, Lord. I'm glad enough. Rest. Oh, All right. We have just a couple more songs. I'm praying. Grab a drink. And ask the Lord. Begin to ask the Father what ails me before you. What causes me not to come? Maybe I'm just not hungry. I'd rather spend time on social media. Be honest. The best thing about God is He already knows. And He still loves us. Because God, come close.
Between your shoulders.
Body.
back to neutral. Bring your left leg forward. Now, knee over ankle. Your knee is never here, always here. Now, if you find yourself reaching for the floor like this, I want you to grab a weight so that your shoulders stay open and your chest stays open. Now, come up to that leg and press forward. After those hip flexors, they get super tight because we sit so much. So now draw your shoulders back, look up, reach, get a little wobbly here, and that's okay. And back to center. Now hands down, flex that foot, take your knee out. It's really important you flex your ankle so that you protect your knee. Sorry, you're protecting your ankle. Now breathe. So all of us who've had the veil removed in Christ can see and reflect the glory of the Lord. And the Lord, who is the Spirit, makes us more and more like Him as we're changed into His glorious image. Inhale, bring it up. Exhale, toes towards your nose. Press your hips back. You can sit down on that back foot if you want. I don't prefer that, but you can. It's not any better or any worse. I just like this way better, so you can try it out, see which way you like better. The goal is, from your heel up into your glutes, we want to stretch the back of that leg. Now gently bring it up, flex that foot a lot. Now, from here, maybe this is enough, maybe you stay here, otherwise, if you can come down a little lower. Again, now be kind to your body. Listen to where your body is today. Now breathe. Increase your breath. Got to breathe into the tight spaces. Now bring it up. Press your hips back. This time keep your toes anchored to the floor. So now we're also getting the front of that foot. Leg at me. Alright, bring it up. Now walk that leg over into pigeon. Square your hips. If you would rather, you can also come here or to seated. Listen to your body in pigeon. We're going to grab to those hips. Alright, so square up. Now you're not going to sit into that leg, the bent leg. Square your hips. Imagine you've got headlights. Now, from there, come down and breathe. So that's switch two. There you go. All right, so we're going to be here for a full minute, and I'm not going to talk. I'll let the Lord talk, so. To work your way up. Now reach back towards the extended leg. Stay here, or if you want, reach for that foot. It's up to you. Keep breathing. Draw your shoulders back. Now release. Come back to all fours. Inhale and exhale. That hip feels like I'm like 15, and the other one feels like 45. All right, other leg forward. So again, if you find yourself grounded, use a weight to bring the floor up. So knee over ankle. Sit up tall, press your hips forward, draw your shoulders back. Deepen your breath. So find a rhythm, maybe inhale for 4 or 5, and then exhale for 6 or 7. A little side bend. Now flex that foot, let that knee come out to breathe. Keep your spine long.
Yeah.
Gently bring the foot back up. Now switch feet. Last of the ball of your right. Extend your left long. Pull your leg in. Now with your heels, make circles on the ceiling.
Loves you because he loves you because he loves you because he loves you because he loves you. Start
started with was all about an open face, an unveiled face. And the verse we're going to end with is the invitation, Jesus, the bridegroom. It says, arise, my love, my beautiful one. I should have pictured Jesus speaking to you. Arise, my love, my beautiful one, and come away. Listen to what he says. He says, let me see your face. Let me hear your voice. For your voice is sweet and your face is lovely. Arise, my love, my beautiful one, and come away. See your face. Let me hear your voice. For your voice is sweet and your face is lovely. Father, we thank you that in Christ we get to come like that. Open-faced, unveiled. No more shame or fear or performance or pride. No more striving and trying harder to be good enough, Lord, but we simply come because Jesus made a way. Jesus, thank you for loving us like this. Thank you that you love us. You'll never unlove us. Pray each one of these daughters, these beautiful women, would hear the invitation to come, to let you see their face. To walk with you, that you declare over them that each one of them is beautiful. They are your beautiful ones. Lord, in a world that rates us by our exterior, thank you, Lord, that you draw us close by our hearts. So, Lord, we choose to come unveiled. And we're hiding. We trust you. Deep breath in and exhale. Now we're going to do it again, but as you inhale this time, I want you to think this thought, I am my beloved's. And then as you exhale, then he is mine. Inhale, I am my beloved's. And exhale, and he is mine. One more time. Jesus, we love you. Father, we adore you. Holy Spirit, we invite you to teach us what it looks like to walk as your beloved in our world. Lord, when the veil slips back, Father, would you nudge us once again to come close, to see your love for us, your glory that transforms us. For your word. Thank you that you are true. It never changes. Father, thank you for bodies that are able and for a community where we can grow. Spirit, soul, and body. So Lord, we love you back and we thank you so much for the gift of this time. In Jesus' name.